بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم يا رب أكرمنا بنور الفهم، وافتح علينا بمعرفة العلم، وسهل أخلاقنا بالحلم، وجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، اللهم آمين. Dear brothers and sisters, we're continuing on the series of doing the best deeds so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with us. One of the most profound hadith that you potentially could come across is the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. The authentic hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meets the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim. He sees them and he says a question that he asked them. And that was one of his ways of teaching the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, where he says, أَتَدْرُونَ مَنِ الْمُفْلِسِ. Do you know who is the person who is bankrupt? And of course, you know, the Sahaba are human beings just like you and me. And their natural tendency was to answer the questions as obvious as they might seem. And sometimes what you see is not the complete insight. And so what they responded was just the most natural response that the person could potentially give. Where the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, they said, قَالُوا أَلْمُفْلِسُ فِينَا, that the bankrupt amongst us, مَلَّا دِرْهَمَ لَهُ وَلَا مَتَعَ, that the person that does not have much money, if you will, liquid money, or property. فقال, and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives them the insight that is much needed, where he says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, المفلس من أمتي من يأتي يوم القيامة بصلاة وصيام وزكاة, that a person who is too bankrupt from my ummah is a person who comes on the day of judgment with a lot of salah, with a siyam, with zakah, charity. And he says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, ويأتي وقد شتم هذا, but then this person comes on the day of judgment where he or she has insulted a person, وقذف هذا, and has accused someone of some kind of act, وأكل مال هذا, and he took the money or property of somebody else, وسفك دم هذا, or might have even killed somebody else, وضرب هذا, or might have hit someone. And then the Prophet ﷺ says, he is just giving us a list of activities that we, you know, would typically do all these activities. First, he mentioned the good deeds that we might do. But then he says that in contrast, the person might be doing X, Y, and Z. And then, you know, because he says that the person bankrupt from the point of view of the day of judgment, then now he says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, on the day of judgment, فيعطي هذا من حسناته, that the person who was doing salah and siyam, he has earned good deeds. But then he gives from the good deeds that he has or she has earned to the person that was hurt, that was impacted, that was insulted, that was hit, so on and so forth, from his or her deeds, he gives it to that person. Because the commodity on the day of judgment is deeds, which is in the commodity now to buy and sell is money and so on and so forth, properties and so on. But on the day of judgment is deeds. So that's what the person owns. And so has to pay off for or pay back the person that he or she has hurt. And so takes from his sins or her sins and gives it to the other person. فَإِنْ فَنِيَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُ. In other words, what if then these hasanat, he keeps on giving and giving and giving, and then it's all gone. قَبْلَ أَنْ يُقْضَى مَا عَلَيْهِ. In a before he or she fulfills what his or her obligation is. أُخِذَ مِنْ خَطَايَاهُمْ. Then the bad deeds of these individuals are taken. And فَطُرِحَتْ عَلَيْهِ. And then it will be put unto him or her. ثُمَّ طُرِحَ فِي النَّارِ. At that point, his bad deeds would outweigh the original good deeds that even originally existed. And so this person will be put in hellfire. Now, this is a very profound hadith that the Prophet ﷺ is warning us. And we, you know, those people that are sometimes thinking that we have done a lot of good deeds. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, in this country has given us the opportunity to serve, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We serve masajid, we serve organizations, we help people, alhamdulillah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah opened doors for us to donate towards organizations, towards masajid, open doors for us to establish masajid even. And so many of us might think, you know, we've done enough. And at times, we might think we almost own that community that we have served. And so once that mentality comes to our head, then we start to be rough. And that roughness at times leads us to either backbite or start to talk ill about others, sometimes even raising our voice inappropriately, sometimes even insulting and so on, because we think we have almost earned it. And that is why the Prophet ﷺ warns the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim that in my ummah, through bankruptcy, are those people that actually actually that have a lot, and then they lose that, not just lose it to zero, but actually end up being on the negative, end up being in the red. And that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is warning us. So when we say وَقُلْ اعْمَلُوا, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah At-Tawbah, ayah 105, make sure you do deeds. You make sure you do deeds, and that does not come to your heart that you are almost, you know, above others. And this, you know, goes sometimes into, we are at times careful with maybe in the masjid because of the image that we have and the people that we work with and so on. But sometimes our roughness goes in terms of the closest people that are to us, our family members, our very close friends, our colleagues, and so on. But the ones that are a little bit distant, we try to maintain that rapport and that image. So we gotta be very careful as believers. We need to be humbled by the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put us in this position to worship Him and to serve others. And so that service comes with also humbleness and being lenient and gentle and kind and nice and merciful towards others. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, to help us understand this and make us among those that listen and practice. Wa salli Allahumma ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Jazakum Allahu khairan.